This tutorial is going to show you how to create a PowerPoint with a voiceover, and you can see here that I've got a PowerPoint already that actually takes you through most of these steps, but I thought it would be useful for you to have the video. Now, the important thing to recognize first is that you must have a microphone attached to your computer, and you must be working with it. I'm on Windows 7 right now. With Windows 7 or Windows 8, you can just go to your little speaker icon here, and you can right-click. And then you can go to recording devices, and you can check to make sure that your microphone is in and that it's working. You can see the little bar is moving up and down as I'm speaking, and that's what you want. On a Mac, it's slightly different, but pretty much the same thing. And so you want to make sure that you do have a microphone working. If you don't, you probably have a microphone jack, and you can just grab a microphone from the help desk or the checkout window at the circulation desk in the library. So what you do basically is you create a PowerPoint the same way you would normally. And you can see that here are my my different slides. And then you, once this is done, then you can move on into actually making the voiceover. And when you're doing the voiceover, basically all you have to do is go into your slideshow tab here. And then you can go into record slideshow. And when you click on this little drop down, you can see that you can record the slideshow from the beginning or from the current slide. You can see that I'm on slide 4 here because the first instruction on how to create a PowerPoint. Here I would probably do start recording from current slide, although it really doesn't matter. What happens when you click this is that it's going to open up the window here. So it'll ask you about your animation timings and narrations, and you want to just go ahead and leave these at the recording. So start recording, and then it will actually open a PowerPoint in another window, which you can't see because it's recording into a different window here. There is a little recording box on there, which looks like this. I just dragged it over. And you can see you can change slides, you can pause it or whatever, and it just tells you how long it's been. You can even repeat one particular bit. So as you go through your slideshow, you actually do are able to put some recordings on each piece. So you just speak for however long you want on each slide, and then you go through and change the slide. So you can see I've moved to slide 5 here, and then you can move to slide 6 and whatnot, and it will all record. So once you're done with this, you can close it out, and you'll see that now on all of the slides that you've recorded, so you can see I didn't record on 1, 2, and 3, right? So there's nothing here. On slide 4, you can see that now I've got audio. And you can actually test that audio here, which you definitely want to do, is test that audio. But in all the slides where I've recorded audio, there is now this little audio icon. So this is a very, very useful thing to do. So you want to start this recording, and then when you're finished, click the X at the top. And then you want to review that recording by going into the little speaker icon. And you can view it in this view so that all the slides are together, or you can view it in just the regular view like we're in right now. And then once you've tested your audio, you can make sure to save the file. So you can save this as just a regular file, which is what I'm going to do now. So now it's saved and the audio is saved in it. And again, notice it's only on 4, 5, and 6. And you know, if you're doing this professionally, of course, you want to have audio on every slide to take us through the slideshow. But in this case, what I want to show you to do is how to export this as a video. So I'm going to go to export and then create a video. I suggest doing computer and HD displays and use recorded narrations and timings. Now, the things here is that the second spent on each slide is only if there is no narration. So you can see those first three slides didn't have narration. So they would have 5 seconds on each slide. And then the others would just go for as long as I've narrated as I'm clicking through the slide. So that first one had a much longer narrative, the other two had smaller ones, and so it will spend as long on the slide as you did when you were actually recording it. Then you simply go to create video, and you can choose your format. I suggest doing MP4s, and then you can simply call it whatever you want, and then save it. And then it will export the file. You can see here it's creating video voiceover PowerPoint. Once that's done, it's ready to be uploaded to YouTube which is obviously a very simple process. Just log into, go to www.youtube.com, log in, or create an account if you don't have one already. It would be the same account as a Gmail account or a Google Drive account if you've got one of those as well. And then you simply click on upload and drag in the file. So it's a very simple process. Thanks so much. Hope this was helpful.